For centuries, one color ruled them all. Purple. But not just any purple. Tyrian purple. A rare, radiant dye so precious, it became the color of emperors, priests, and royalty. Now, archaeologists have uncovered one of the most important sources of this legendary substance. Right on the Mediterranean coast, in modern-day Israel. Welcome to Tel Shikmona, an unassuming coastal site that, between the 11th and 6th centuries BCE, was anything but modest. What began as a simple fishing village blossomed into a powerful industrial hub for one of the ancient world's most coveted luxury goods. A team led by archaeologist Golan Shalvi of the University of Chicago has unearthed over 170 artifacts tied to ancient dye-making. They found large vats used for extracting pigment, tools, and even ancient surfaces still stained with a rich, purplish hue. What's so special about this purple? It came from the Muricidae, a family of sea snails that produced a tiny amount of mucus. Through an elaborate and rather smelly chemical process, this secretion was transformed into a durable dye, the deep red-purple color we now know as Tyrian purple. And when we say smelly, we mean it.
I imagine this place smelled absolutely awful, but everything here glowed with that red-purple-blue hue.
Golan Shalvi, archaeologist, University of Chicago. Tel Shikmona was no temporary facility. Despite the political chaos that shook the region, conquests, empire collapses, new regimes, the site kept operating for centuries. It finally shut down in the 6th century BCE, but its legacy lingered. The dye produced here didn't just color fabrics, it shaped history. Tyrian purple was more than a color. It became a symbol of divine power, sacred authority, and elite status. Reserved for kings, priests, and the highest officials, wearing purple was, quite literally, a statement of power. What makes the discovery at Tel Shikmona so unique isn't just the number of artifacts, it's the scale, continuity, and historical implications. Until now, much of what we knew about Tyrian purple came from Roman-era sources or fragmentary Phoenician texts. But this find offers physical proof of an earlier long-standing production center, bridging myth, archaeology, and material culture. So the next time you see a royal robe in a museum or a purple banner in a video game, remember the snails, the stench, and the ancient artisans of Tel Shikmona. They weren't just dye makers, they were engineers of prestige.